Thank you. I'd like to welcome you all to Baccalaureate 2015 for ORHS High School. Actually, tonight is kind of a historic night. This is the first time that Baccalaureate and Friday graduation as well will be live broadcast on our local cable channel, as well as live streaming video, so people who are not able to be here tonight can see it as well. So you're a part of history, so welcome. I would like to start by saying what a special night Baccalaureate is in the ORHS River community. Historically, Baccalaureate is an event that really is about bringing the class together that one last time before they gather at commencement, in which they go off and after they graduate and they go off into the world. But this is the last official class meeting prior to that. At ORHS River High School, we've made it a tradition to have Baccalaureate really be about honoring our graduates. We do that by awarding multiple scholarships and having multiple awards given out, in addition to having a number of our talented performing artists perform and entertain us. I hope you'll find it's a very enjoyable and moving night for everybody involved. I would like to thank all the various community members who are here tonight to present the various awards that are about to be given out. I would say I've worked in this district now for 30 years, and I know that says I'm old, but besides that, it has given me the opportunity to know an awful lot of the people who these awards are in memory of. I was very fortunate to have known many of these people, and I think they really are all great examples of the exceptional characteristics that are in the ORHS River community. And as we award these awards tonight, I hope that the recipients recognize that their role is to kind of carry on those important values that all these scholarships and awards are geared towards. So, without further ado, I would like to introduce Dave Hawley, the president of the Teachers Guild, to present the ORHS River Teachers Guild Scholarship.
It's truly an honor to kick off this great event and be one of the first people to say congratulations to the class of 2015. Woo-hoo, you guys have come a long way. You can let the crowd please. So, the Teachers Guild, we're committed to the betterment of education for our students, and we realized a long time ago that that is not just a conversation in high school, but we should start looking into assistance beyond the walls of ORHS River. So back in 1981, a bunch of teachers got together and said, you know, it'd be a great thing to start a scholarship. And they did it by starting a dance, which is kind of shocking to us now, because one thing that teachers don't want to do is chaperone another dance. It initially started with $250 for one graduate. It's gone to $1,000 for two graduates. And we've awarded those to folks who have displayed great character, academic excellence, and just all around excellent people. And I'm honored today to award this to Keenan Grove and Morgan Smith.
Morgan Smith is the person that's supposed to do the next award.
Yeah, Keenan.
Thank you.
Not with Morgan Smith individual. She's filling in for Meredith Freeman Capel and giving the Dramatic Arts Award.
Good evening. My name is Morgan Smith, and I won last year's Performing Arts Scholarship. Ms. Capel is directing a show in Portsmouth, and I am honored to be here in her place. She has asked me to share the following words. Quote, to be a great actor, one must be smart. To be a great actor, one must be curious about the world, about psychology, sociology, and the environment. To be a great actor, one must have an empathetic soul that can relate to so many types of people so that one can, what I call, drop into the character. A great actor must inhabit their being. The person who has earned this scholarship possesses all of the above qualities, so my advice to this actor is commit, commit, commit. Always show up to stand out. Take many risks in the acting space. Don't be afraid to look stupid or feel judged, for you are enough. I love you, Mama Cates, or to you now, your friend Meredith. End quote. I am so honored as an alum and former recipient of this scholarship to now be able to present the 2015 Performing Arts Scholarship to Alana Bennett.
The scholarship fund is awarded to a scholar athlete who is college-bound. The award recognizes demonstrated interest and accomplishment in a classroom in concert with exceptional qualities of team play, leadership by example, and school spirit. While these characteristics reveal themselves in the competitive atmosphere of sports, their essence transcends athletics. The criteria are meant to remind us of Brian's love of life, persistence in the face of adversity, and commitment to the school. This year's recipient is Sophie Webb. And next, I'd like to invite Mrs. Burr up to present the Chief Burr Scholarship.
Named in memory of Chief of Police Ray I. Burroughs, a native and long life resident of Durham, who served the community from 1957 to 1979. Chief Burroughs dedicated his career to maintaining a high standard in law enforcement and molding an efficient full-time police department as a result of his long life efforts. Burroughs passed away in June of 1979 while still in office. Upon his death, a memorial fund was established from which the scholarship is being presented tonight. The scholarship is awarded on the basis of career interest in law enforcement, human services, need, scholarship, and citizenship.
The scholarship tonight is awarded to, in the amount of $500 is awarded to Sydney Simmons.
Good evening. One of the hats that I wear here in the school district is chair of the high school PTO. And it is our pleasure to present this year's Lynn Little PTO Award for Volunteerism. The Lynn Little PTO Award is given by the PTO of Oyster River School District, the high school, the middle school, Meharry, and Massway Elementary Schools. It is given to a member of the senior class who exemplifies the spirit of generous service to the school and community and acts upon that spirit. This year from the Oyster River High School class of 2015, I'm pleased to recognize Victoria Wichwalski. Victoria. I get to stay here for the next part. So again, it continues to be a real honor to be here tonight to recognize the select group of seniors as New Hampshire Scholars. When I was asked to represent the New Hampshire Scholars Program tonight, they asked that I offer my comments not only as the Executive Director of the University of New Hampshire's Thompson School, but also as a representative of New Hampshire's entire higher education community. I'm excited too because I am a parent of graduates from the classes of 2011 and 2014, and I'm a rising senior here for 2016, which is really, really scary because then I won't be here anymore. While I won't presume to speak for every college in New Hampshire on this topic, I can say with confidence that every college and university in New Hampshire recognizes how important academic preparation is to a student's future success, both in whatever formal education pathway they choose, and if they are smart, which I know what your students are, each one of you will participate in some type of education beyond this campus, and also preparing you for the workplace. Increasing student learning expectations is one of the most effective ways that I know to ensure continued success. And by challenging students to take a more rigorous academic program, we are helping to better equip them with the tools they need to succeed, both in their education beyond high school and in their chosen field of work, as this millennial generation will likely have more than one career path over their lifetime. The students receiving New Hampshire Scholars Medallions tonight have met the challenge. I am particularly pleased that the State Scholars Program, working cooperatively with the New Hampshire College and University Council and the Oyster River High School teachers, staff, and administrators, focused on the need to significantly raise expectations for all of our students by encouraging academic rigor and participation by as many students as possible, as you will see tonight. So let me be first to congratulate the seniors who successfully completed New Hampshire Scholars curriculum here at Oyster River. You are the sixth group of its kind. You have challenged yourself academically, and for this, you will find yourself better prepared intellectually, and most importantly, have obtained the skills and knowledge that today's employers look for as we eventually find ourselves in the workplace. So congratulations to you, and Mr. Allen will come and read the names, and you'll come forward and receive your medallion to wear on Friday for congratulations. So congratulations once again to 2015, which was New Hampshire Scholars.
Okay, I'm gonna ask, as I read your names, if you could please come up on stage right, I think I'm saying that right, where I'm pointing, come up on this side, thank you, and exit on stage left, right? Okay, good, that's what I'm asking you to do, so thank you. So I'm gonna read through the whole list, if we could save the applause till the end, because fortunately for us, we have students of extremely high aspirations, and so we have a number of kids to honor here. Madeline Abbott. Cameron Alstrom, Aaron Albert, Jake Aldrich, Peter Antignetti, Casey Aubin, Alana Bagman, Michaela Baldy, Isabel Banker, Rebecca Barsky, Annika Barr, Cameron Barr, Amy Batchelor, Nick Bergeron, Devin Bowen, Brianna Burt, Liam Cahill, Darian Castro Delgado, Ella Cedarholm, Heidi Cheddar, Elizabeth Celia, Ella St. Mars, Olivia Clark, Christopher Clement, Sedona Clothier, Abigail Colby, Sam Colby, Abigail Concannon, Caitlin Coxon, Emily Cruz, Tom Cusack, Dominic Dentilio,
Sydney Gagel, Melanie Daniels, Luke Davison, Connor Detula, Amira Diamond-Deer, Rachel Dehars, Abigail Donovan, Mike Doyen, Deanna Briscott, Peter Dubois, Haley Dunning, Jonathan Dutka, Caitlin Emmett, Josh Kennedy, Grace Fisher, Hannah Flaherty, Marissa Flynn, Ben Freed, James Glass, Katie Getz, Natalia Gorslon, Keenan Grove, Jackson Hale, Amy Halstead, Emily Halstead, Catherine Howard, Jeremy Howland, Sam Houston, Erica Ireland, Zephyr Yeager, Francesca Jeffrey, Tyler Jones, Nick Kahn, Desiree O'Han, Mary Lapham, Katie Lasher, Niles Lawson, Eliza Lewis, Abby Limerick, Samantha Londrigan, Sean Lutz, Lars Luxem, Sarah Mayer, Owen McCabe, Belinda McCormick, Connor McDonough, Brendan McKenna, Peter Miller, Charlotte Moore, Sadie Moore, Alexander Morales, Alex Moikas, Leah Mueller, Patrick Mulhern, Megan Neal, Claire O'Connell, Liam O'Rourke, Haley Perry, Ben Patton, Jordan Petrovitsis, Will Pollard, Anna Fawcett, Leslie Richard, Kristen Sack, Alana Sarabon, Bryce Schultz, Marina Schwadron, Amy Short, Elizabeth Silvio, Siobhan Slavin, Eric Spann, Sam Smith, Sydney Snelling, Samantha Stewart, Will Stone, Tim Stringer, Olivia Svanholm, Grace Torriello, Ashley Tewksbury, Neil Thomas, Michael Titterington, Gregory Trueblood, Matt Walsh, Riley Webb, Sophie Webb, Dylan Weglars, Kirsten Weicker, Madeline Young, Adele Zemek, and Peter Zwolf. Let's hear it for all of our students.
Happy Days Are Here Again, originally by Barbara Streisand and Judy Garland.
Forget your troubles. Beautiful singing, girls. Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. My name is Carden Welsh, incidentally father of four Oyster River graduates. And I have the honor this evening of awarding the Oyster River Environmental Sustainability Award. When you think about sustainability, it is interesting to note the role that has been played by this district. First, the serious, very early thinking about sustainability came from the district's own resident, Dennis Meadows, who published the groundbreaking work, The Limits to Growth. His efforts spurred a worldwide debate in the early 1970s on the limits of the planet's ability to sustain economic expansion. Subsequently, all of our towns have become leaders in sustainability, with significant efforts in solar energy, water conservation, land preservation, and wastewater treatment. Now our school district has become a leader in sustainability, and we are pleased that this year's winners are adding to that tradition. This award is designed to honor students who have shown initiative, leadership, and commitment to sustainable practices at Oyster River. This year, we are awarding three scholarships, as the work of all three students has been exemplary. The first award goes to Sophie Webb. Sophie had what she called crazy fun working to revitalize the school's composting program. Thank you, sir. The next scholarship goes to Elizabeth Celia. Elizabeth, inspired by her Power of One project, has helped with composting and organized a program to get the middle school involved in Earth Week.
Thank you very much. Congratulations.
And last but not least, we are awarding another scholarship to Marissa Flynn. Marissa, whose grandfather encouraged her interest in nature, has been working to reduce the school's carbon footprint, improve composting, and investigate the possibility of a solar energy project.
Congratulations.
By the way, all of the winners mentioned the inspiration that they have received from Oyster River teacher John Bromwick. So a big shout out to John. Congratulations to all three winners, and good luck next year. And I'd like to introduce the next presenter, Professor Stephen Hardy.
After 20 years, I've convinced Donna to come up here with me. After all, she's the one who really began the Josh Hardy Award. The Josh and Nate Hardy Awards are funded in several ways, including the annual raffle of a hand-stitched sampler quilt. How's that? That Donna makes, plus support from the Bobcat Bolt, the Oyster River Alumni Association, and many individual donors. Both Josh and Nate taught us that no matter how hard life gets, life is still worth living. The winners of these awards exemplify that spirit. Josh died of a brain tumor in 1993, his senior year at Oyster River High School. The Josh Hardy Art Award is given to a graduating senior who has found the art room to be a special place for growth and development. It is determined by the teachers. This year's award winner arrived to the art room somewhat late in her high school career, but she immediately had an impact on the teachers who saw the tremendous ability she had, and after one class, they convinced her to take an advanced class in art, after one drawing class, because her talent stood out so much. She plans on pursuing the arts at Keene State College. Katie Young. Each year, the coaches and athletic director Corey Parker pick a male and female varsity athlete who best exemplifies what needs stood for on and off the field: physical and mental toughness, leadership, and determination. This year's male winner earned an overall GPA of 3.34, was a four-year varsity boys soccer player, captain his senior year, and led his team to a state final appearance. His coach said he is the embodiment of what any coach strives for in a student athlete: hardworking, passionate, leads by voice and example, and is humble. He gave everything he could in his 4 years and truly left the program in a better place. He's going to Thomas College this fall. John Duca. This year's female winner earned an overall GPA of 3.59. She is a four-year varsity field hockey player and a four-year indoor and outdoor track participant. Her coaches praised her amazing dedication to developing her skills. Her field hockey coach said she embodied the qualities you hope a team captain will exude. She is an exceptional leader with a positive attitude. As Babe Ruth said, you just can't beat the person who won't give up. She's going to take a gap year before attending the University of Vermont. Melissa Flynn. And Anita Mather will now come up and give out the first year of the Alumni Association Award.
The vision of the Oyster River Alumni Association is to strengthen the Oyster River community by facilitating alumni networking and communication, providing funds in support of Oyster River students, events, and projects, and increasing awareness of current Oyster River issues. Today, we've raised nearly $40,000 in support of Oyster River youth initiatives. Every year since 2009, the Alumni Association has hosted the Bobcat Gold 5K Run Walk and Kids Fun Run as an all-alumni reunion and community event. Proceeds from the race benefit the Oyster River Alumni Scholarship and Service Award that I'm giving out today, as well as the Josh and Nick Hardy Awards and the Alumni Association Mini-Grant Initiative. We hope to see you and your friends and family back here at Oyster River High School Saturday, June 28th, for the 7th annual Bobcat Bolt 5K and Kids Fun Event. You can walk or run the 5K, which starts at 9 a.m., or simply come anytime between 9 and 11 a.m. to hear the middle school jazz band play and enjoy a fabulous pancake breakfast. So now for the awards. The Oyster River Alumni Association Service Award goes to a graduating senior who has volunteered a significant amount of time and energy helping the association with fundraising events and generating student awareness of the organization. The Oyster River Alumni Association Scholarship goes to a graduating senior who has demonstrated talent and enthusiasm for Oyster River community organizing and is likely to continue those efforts in the future. It is my honor and pleasure to present the 2015 Alumni Association Service Award to Caitlin Lasher and the 2015 Alumni Association Scholarship for Oyster River Community Organizing to Catherine Howard. Caitlin couldn't be here tonight, but we'll make sure she gets a check. But Catherine can join me, that would be great.
Thank you. My name is Celeste Best. I'm a science teacher here at the high school, and I'm also co-advisor of the National Honor Society. Tonight with me is a very special guest, Mrs. Kimberly Lawton, the daughter of Shirley Thompson and an Oyster River graduate. The Shirley Thompson Service Award is given in the memory of Shirley Thompson, a lifelong member of the Oyster River community. Shirley dedicated her life to serving the community that she held so dear to her heart. Her passion for education and public service were evident in the many ways she tried to better the place that we all call home. This award will be given each year to a deserving member of the senior class who is a member of the National Honor Society and who has demonstrated a passion and desire to serve those of the Oyster River community. Shirley wore many hats of service, from serving as a playground supervisor when her children were small, to spending over 20 years tutoring math and reading at Mount Harriman Elementary School. Many of you may have had her. She governed our school board, ensuring all children attending our schools received the best education possible. Shirley also served as a select woman for the town, chaired the Durham Fire Department Ladies Auxiliary, and served as fire commissioner. I'm just tired thinking about all of that. The list goes on, but as you can see, Shirley did not like to have idle hands. In her 80 years, she did everything in her power to make Durham, Lee, and Nagberry a better place to live and raise a family. Some of you might be wondering why I have a teddy bear. Shirley was known to carry a trunk full of teddy bears in her car. It stemmed from her work with the Durham Fire Department when she wanted to have something to comfort children at the scene of a fire. In later years, she worked with teachers here at ORHS to do teddy bear drives for local hospitals and orphanages. And sometimes, she just gave them to people who were having a tough time to make them smile. So we wanted to carry on that tradition as part of this award. Tonight, I am honored to present this $500 scholarship and a teddy bear to a young lady that exhibits a similar dedication to service as Shirley did. She has spent her years of high school closely working with the St. Thomas More Food Pantry, as well as the homeless shelter Crossroads House, not to mention all of her hours dedicated to NHS service here at the high school. She hopes to continue her work with these two charities the next 4 years while she attends the University of New Hampshire. She's hoping to pursue a career in elementary education and help young people get involved with service in their community. It is my honor and pleasure to present the Shirley Thompson Service Award to Caitlin Coxon.
From 7 states throughout the New England. And please present the scholarship to Ashley Shipsbury.
Congratulations on your upcoming graduation from high school.
It's an exciting time in your life, and you've made a decision to get an education in the beauty industry by choosing Empire Beauty School. The beauty industry is a multi-billion dollar industry with a 0% unemployment rate. With a license in cosmetology, you have countless career opportunities, no limit on how much income you can make, and it's also self-rewarding. It is with great pleasure, on behalf of Empire Beauty Schools, the entire Langlois family, and myself, to present you with a $1,000 scholarship for Savannah Lavin.
Scholarship to Caitlin Hodson.
seven area high schools. Their siblings plan to pursue a career in health-related fields and then credited four or two-year school. This year, the scholarship is awarded to Alex Moore.
Yeah, well, I'm a flute player. It's gonna be pretty quiet.
Thank you.
My wife, Ann Murdoch, was a graduate of St. Luke's Hospital Nursing School in Cleveland, Ohio, and of Hiram College in Hiram, Ohio, where she was also the college nurse. After we moved to New Hampshire, she worked as a nurse at the Wentworth Douglas Hospital and at the Wentworth Home for the Aged. She also volunteered her nursing skills in Red Cross activities and in providing private duty nursing for many people in the Seacoast area. All five of her children and four of her grandchildren have
I graduated from Oyster River High School. And one grandchild is graduating this Friday. In the St. Luke's 1950 yearbook, there is a short phrase beside each graduate's picture. Anne's reads, quote, "an alabaster box full of precious jewels," unquote. The scholarship in Anne's name will be given this year to Alexandra May Morrill, who will be pursuing a degree in nursing at West Virginia University.
Hi, my name is John O'Brien, and I was a graduate of Oyster River High School in 2010. Most of you probably didn't know Oliver, but for those of you that did, I'm sure that you can agree with me that he is a very worthy representative of this scholarship. He definitely lived his life to the fullest, and he liked to focus his free time on skateboarding, humanitarian efforts, and just having fun. And in that same time, he was able to be a great student with straight A's and make everyone laugh in the meantime. This award goes to Erica Ireland.
Good evening. It is a distinct pleasure and honor to be with you tonight. And I'd like to congratulate all the seniors and get ready to achieve a very significant milestone in your lives. And also like to recognize all of the scholarships, being able to hear all the significance of the memorials. We are both truly touched to be invited to be a part of tonight's ceremony. And we'd also like to thank Oyster River High School for inviting us. My name is Lieutenant Colonel Brian A. I'm with the United States Army as a professor of military science here at the University of New Hampshire. Also with me is Master Sergeant Mark Woodworth, who is our senior military science instructor, and then also Command Sergeant Major retired Joseph LaPlante. The three of us are here on behalf of the Department of the United States Army to present a national U.S. Army ROTC scholarship. Just a little bit about a National Army ROTC scholarship. This scholarship provides full college tuition. It also provides full educational fees for the recipient. The scholarship also provides an additional allowance for all textbooks, school supplies, and any type of special equipment that they might need. In addition to these benefits, the scholarship also provides an education grant for each of the 4 years at the university. It comes to an additional total of $16,000 that recipient can use each year that he's at the university. Tonight, the United States Army will be awarding a scholarship that is valued at $143,972.
To put the national scholarships in perspective, this year over 6,000 high school seniors applied and competed for the U.S. Army National Scholarship. 1,000 were selected. Oyster River High School is one of this year's awardees. Tonight's recipient, upon completion of his bachelor's degree at the Rochester Institute of Technology, will automatically receive a presidential appointment as a commissioned officer in the grade of second lieutenant. Some of his personal accomplishments this year, or his high school career, were carrying a 3.4 cumulative GPA, scoring 1200 on the SAT score, and playing varsity baseball as well as golf, on top of donating numerous personal hours to community organizations and community services. Please join me in a round of applause for this year's 2015 National U.S. Army Scholarship winner, Mr. Timothy Stringer.
Peter Grant Wild Ride Adventure Scholarship. Good evening, everybody. I'm not Adriana Grant. My name is Steve Wargiotis, class of 1991. Barely graduated, but I did. I'm here today to award Peter Grant Wild Ride Adventure Scholarship, which is given in honor of my very good friend and Oyster classmate who passed away from melanoma in 2004. He had an adventurous soul. He was equally willing to dive into a physics or engineering problem, as windsurf into a coming hurricane, or retackle a rock cliff after a fall. For those of us who knew him, Peter simply redefined what was possible. And it's our hope that this scholarship will nurture new adventurers to follow in Peter's wide-ranging footsteps. It's my honor and pleasure to award Patrick Mulhern. So Patrick is gonna get a check. Patrick also gets a photograph of Peter heading off to El Capitan, Yosemite. So never give up. And this, I'm not going to go into the details of how the scholarship is chosen, but for this, our recipients must really have their heads screwed on tight, but probably one screw a little loose.
Now we will have another musical selection.
Just call out called my name, and you'll know wherever I am, I'll come running. If the sky should grow dark and fill with clouds, and that old north wind begin to blow, just keep your head tight and think of me, and call my name out loud, and soon you'll hear me knocking at your door. You just call out my name, and you'll know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you have to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Oh, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend when people can be so cold? Call out my name, and you'll know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Yes, I will. You've got a friend. You've got a friend. You've got a friend.
To go to Desert Shield, where he died
during a night training mission. This scholarship has been established to recognize the joy and positive attributes that Michael infectiously loved of life and bold spirit embodied, and to help a senior who shares his dreams and values. It is my pleasure to present for Michael's parents, Pete and Ellen Chinberg, and his three brothers, the 2015 Michael Leo Chinberg Scholarship to Timothy Stringers.
Congratulations to the class of 2015. Bob and I are here this evening to award her scholarship in memory of our son, Todd, who passed away in an athletic accident during his second year at West Point Military Academy. In his senior year at ORHS, Todd was voted the best player on the field when the Bobcats won the state soccer championship, was awarded best defenseman in hockey, and was captain of the tennis team. We'd like to thank this graduating class and the community in general for your continued support of Todd's Trot 5K, the primary funding source for this $5,000 scholarship. For many presenters tonight, the scholarships were created out of a tragedy or loss, and our deepest worry is that our loved one will be forgotten. These scholarships help to reassure us that this will not happen and that something good can come from that loss.
As with many of these scholarships, a committee of teachers and administrators select a recipient from a group of very deserving students. In her essay, the award winner wrote about her appreciation for the sacrifices that are made not only by our service men and our service women, but also to the families they leave behind. She participates in numerous high school sports, rose to Great Bay Rowing, and is interested in the study of environmental sustainability at college. We are pleased to present this award to Elizabeth Cilio.
Service Scholarship is an honor awarded by the Red Sox Foundation, the official team charity of the Boston Red Sox. Through the New Hampshire Red Sox Service Scholarship Program, the Red Sox Foundation will award $1,000 scholarships to 45 academically talented New Hampshire Public High School seniors who have shown a commitment to community service. This prestigious scholarship award is for students pursuing a 2 or 4 year degree at any college, university, or trade school. In spite of the fact that she's a Yankees fan, I am pleased to present this Scott, the 2015 Red Sox Service Foundation Scholarship to Caitlin Cox. Another musical selection by our seniors.
Yeah, don't.
Whatever. I don't like him this way. He's
gonna Are we gonna share this one?
Yes, okay, we can share it.
No, she needs one.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna have to share.
Jaguru Deva Nothing's gonna change my world. Nothing's gonna change my world. Nothing's gonna change my world.
Images of broken light which dance before me like a million eyes. They call me on and on across the universe. Thoughts meander like a restless wind inside a letterbox. They tumble blindly as they make their way across the universe. Gurudeva, nothing's gonna change my world.
Nothing's gonna change my world. Nothing's gonna change my world. Sounds of laughter, shades of earth are ringing through my open ears, inciting and inviting me. This legendary love which shines around me like a million suns and calls me on and on across the universe. Jai Guru Deva.
Nothing's gonna change my world.
Nothing's gonna change my world. Nothing's gonna change my world. Jai Guru Deva.
Jai Guru. Jai Guru Deva.
Very nice. Something from my era. My name is Craig Walfield, and I'm the head baseball coach here at ORHS River High School. I'm here tonight to present the Matt Sarno Scholarship. Matt Sarno Scholarship exemplifies the values and dreams Matt lived by. Although Matt excelled in all sports, his greatest passion was baseball, where he showcased his hard work, determination, and focus. As ORHS River's head baseball coach, it's my honor to continue the tradition of presenting this award to a student-athlete who reflects Matt's perseverance and dedication. This year's recipient was an easy decision for me. This young man, from day one, showed his determination, focus, work ethic towards himself and his team, always putting the team first and always giving 100% of himself each time he settled in behind the plate. I'm very proud and pleased to present this year's Matt Sarno Scholarship to Tim Stringer. Very proud of Tim and the direction that he's chose to go. If I could invite up Mr. Jim Rosicki.
Good evening. My name is Jim Rosicki. I have the pleasure of serving as Facilities Director here for the ORHS River School Department. I'm actually employed by Aramark, which is a facilities management company for facility operations at K-12 and higher education facilities around the U.S. and world. And we probably served on the ORHS River for over 20 years. Since 2009, Aramark has awarded a scholarship to an ORHS River High School senior interested in pursuing a degree in engineering, environmental science, or environmental education to recognize our mutual commitment and efforts to promote environmental awareness and stewardship. And working with the High School Guidance Counseling Office for a candidate selection, one student stood out among the rest. She will be majoring in engineering at UNH this fall, and I'm proud to present this scholarship to Ella Stevenheim.
We are happy to be able to present the 2015 Federal Savings Bank Scholarship to one very lucky lady this evening. Federal Savings Bank launched the scholarship program to recognize and support future leaders of our community. It's the bank's belief that investing today in the youth of our communities will only enhance the quality of life for future generations. Pleased to announce, the recipient of a $1,000 scholarship has not only excelled in the classroom, but has served as a role model for her peers and has contributed to her community through her volunteer efforts. Proud to present the 2015 Federal Savings Bank Scholarship to Isabel Banker.
So
name is Ben. Great night. One last round of applause to all of our award recipients. Another round of applause for all of our presenters. And then a third round of applause for all of our graduates. Before I let you go, I did want to just quickly just remind the graduating class here of what's happening this week, just so you know what's going on. Remember, tomorrow you have the senior trip, Fort Foster, great time. Thursday, don't forget, we have a graduation rehearsal at 10 o'clock. Okay? But also, Friday, we have senior breakfast, new tradition, 8:30. Come on in, eat, and then we'll have a rehearsal at 10 o'clock. We'll be ready for marching. You know, obviously, there's an awful lot going on this week. I do want to just say to you guys, make sure to take time to enjoy it. You only graduated from high school once, and it's a great time. It's a great time to really look ahead to the life you're going to be living after high school, but enjoy it while you have it, because you'll be amazed in the blink of an eye, you're going to be on to something else. So anyway, congratulations to all our winners, and have a wonderful evening, and I will see you all Friday night for graduation.